Residents all across East Texas still trying to deal with what's left of a very dangerous storm. Scot Pankey, who lives in Houston, joins us live. Scot, good of you to take the time. I trust that you're well enough. Set the scene for us in your neighborhood.
Hey, Micah, it is absolutely devastating. Our neighborhood is one of the luckiest ones. We've got a few more feet. I don't know if you can see down here. We've got a few more feet before it hits the door. And we're really blessed in that area, but there's so many people in Houston that have lost everything. They've lost their homes, they've lost their cars. It's heartbreaking.
Yeah, to see the livelihoods destroyed in a matter of hours is difficult to watch for anyone. What's been remarkable in all of this from my vantage point is the sort of citizen navy that has come to bear here in helping so many people in need, not just residents of Texas, but residents of states west of Texas that have actually driven their boats into the floodwaters to try and help people. Have you seen any of that sort of rescue operation?
Yeah, I have to brag on Houstonians. They are incredible. Their spirit is just awe-inspiring. I mean, they have got out, they've gotten their own personal boats, their jet skis, they've gone and rescued people. We've had people from Louisiana, from New Mexico, Arizona. I mean, people from all over that have come and helped us. And we're so thankful for everyone. It's really difficult to get out of the city, and it's really difficult to get into the city right now. But for somehow they made a way, and we're so thankful for it.
Scot, nothing short of historic flooding. What was it like in your community leading up to this storm? The warnings that were going out from officials, were you expecting anything the level of what you're seeing?
You know, it's really interesting. We were watching the news, and on Friday, Saturday, we were walking around the neighborhood. It was just a little bit of rain, and sometimes there would be 3 or 4 hours that was completely dry enough to, the streets were dry. And then all of a sudden on Saturday night, it just hit. And it's basically been raining ever since. They're saying that we're expected to get another 20 inches of rain today, tonight, and tomorrow. So keep us in your prayers.
That is remarkable, Scot. We will for sure. Talk about your immediate plans the next 24, 36 hours. What are you going to do?
Well, we're going to keep an eye on the water in our neighborhood and our front yard. Like I said, it's just a few feet away from our front door. I wish that we had some type of boat or, you know, huge car or truck or something that we could get out there and help people. But we also want to make sure that we're being careful and we're being safe. They're telling us to stay into our house. If we don't have to be on the road, don't get on the road. So we're following those directions.
Scot Pankey with us by way of Skype tonight from Houston. Our best to you going forward. We wish you all the best as you deal with a remarkable situation in Texas. Harvey has forced the cancellation of